Have you ever seen numbers that look like this? Or this? Or this? Those are decimals. Today, we're going to be talking about what decimals are and where we see them in the real world. Let's get into it.
Doodly-doodle, doodly-doodle, doodly-doodles and digits. Area, symmetry, fractions too. It's all here for you.
Okay, so what is a decimal? Decimals are a way to show numbers that are less than one. They use a decimal point right here. Everything to the left of the decimal is going to be a whole number, and everything to the right of the decimal is going to be less than one, or a fraction. That's why sometimes you'll hear decimals described as decimal fractions. What does that mean? So, a picture usually helps. So as you can see, when we're talking about whole numbers, we had ones, and once we got to 10 ones, we went to the tens place. And once we got to 10 tens, we went to the hundreds place. If you want more information on place value, you can check out our other video. But what happens when the number is less than one whole? That's where decimals come in. So look at this. Now we have tenths, hundredths, and thousandths. What does that even mean? We're gonna take our whole and divide our whole into 10 pieces. These are tenths. This is what 1/10, 2/10, 3/10, 4/10, 5/10, 6/10, 7/10, 8/10, 9/10, and 10/10 look like. Notice that 10/10 make one whole. Then, to get to the hundredths, we're going to take those tenths and divide them into 10 pieces themselves to get hundredths. So this same whole is now broken into 100 pieces. These are hundredths. So this is what 100th, 200th, 300th, 400th, 500th, 600th. Okay, I won't go through all of these, but you can count each individual hundredths in the hundredths place. Notice that 10 hundredths make 1/10. All right, we're going to now take those hundredths and divide by 10 again. Each piece is going to be divided into 10. So that same whole is now divided into thousandths. What do you notice? What do you wonder? So again, we can count by thousandths. 1,000, 2,000, 3,000, 4,000, and so on and so forth. What do you notice happens when we get to 10,000ths? That's right, it's the same as 1/100th. Okay, what if we have 100,000ths? That's right, that's the same as 1/10. Where do we see decimals in real life?
Decimals are all around us in our world. Where do you see decimals in your life?
For example, you might see them in money, with prices at a store. You might see them when you're tracking times of how fast you can run or how fast you can swim. You might see them in stock prices. You might even see them in measurements. I know when I'm looking at decimals, a place value chart can be very helpful. What do you notice about this place value chart? What do you wonder?
You might notice that there's a similar pattern in the whole numbers and the decimals. Look, there's tens, hundreds, thousands, 10,000ths. In the decimals, it's tenths, hundredths, thousandths. Each decimal place value ends in THS.
All right, so how many place values are there of decimals?
Just like how whole numbers can get larger and larger and go on indefinitely, so can decimals. Decimals can also go on indefinitely. One decimal you might have heard of that does this is the special decimal pi.
There's actually a few different ways we can show decimal place value. The first is with models. Let's see if we can figure out what decimal this model is showing. What do you think?
Use the place value chart to help you. First, we're going to determine how many this whole is divided into. It's divided into tenths, so we're going to be writing our number in the tenths place. All right, how many tenths do we have? we have 2 tenths, so our decimal is 0.2.
All right, let's try looking at another model.
All right, we're gonna use the place value chart again. This whole is broken into hundredths, so the number we're going to put in the hundredths place. How many hundredths do we have? That's right, we have 6 hundredths. Since we have 6 hundredths and we have 0 tenths, we're gonna put a 0 in the tenths place. So our answer is 0.06.
Now that we've named a few different decimals, let's see if we can draw models of these ones.
All right, we have 0.7 or 7 tenths. So I'm going to take my whole and break it into tenths. Then I'm going to shade in 7 tenths. Let's try this one, 0.21 or 21 hundredths. I'm gonna break my whole into hundredths. Then I'm going to shade in 21 hundredths.
Now that we've done a few together, let's see if you can identify these decimals on your own.
Remember, you can pause this and rewind it if you need more time. This decimal is 4 tenths or 0.4. This model is showing 5 hundredths or 0.05. This model is showing 15 hundredths or 0.15. This model is showing 15 thousandths or 0.015.
All right, how'd you do?
Find more videos and other information at doodleslearning.com.